been proclaimed ever since. Now there is disturbing new evidence that he was wrongly executed.
Mum, somebody somewhere knows the truth and will come forward. No matter what happens, we know that the country has made a terrible mistake.
My name is Valerie Jean Storie. I am a civil servant. I work at the Road Research Laboratory, and I am a scientific assistant. I knew Michael John Gregston. He worked at the Road Research Laboratory. It was there I got to know him. On the 22nd of August, I saw Michael Gregston in the evening. When we got to the cornfield, we just pulled in about 5 or 6 feet from the road. It was late evening, not quite twilight. I had been to that same place before. We were there just over half an hour before anything happened. We were both very scared and asked the man what he wanted. We asked him not to shoot. We left the cornfield with Mike driving and the man in the back seat behind Mike. The gun was pointing at Mike. He said, "Keep facing the front and don't look round." At intervals he would say, "Turn right here, turn left here." After we had been on the A6 for a while, he said, "We'll have to stop so I can have a kip." He said, "Turn off here." There appeared to be a dead end. The man said, "Turn the car around and stop." He said, "Turn the lights out." The man said to Mike, "Pass that bag over." Mike picked the bag up. He said, "Get out of the car." He pointed the gun at me and said, "Get in. If you don't get in, I'll shoot."